Hi guys, this is Doug's Dogs. I just want to see my hot dog play. I'm sitting in my courthouse. I'm going to go ahead and shoot this. But anyway, there's my big dog. This is a 2018 big dog. I bought this in 2018. Yeah, brand new. And the difference in my big dog and most people's big dogs is I don't have a condiment tray back here. All I have is a flat blank shelf. And you can order it this way. This was actually built especially for me. But I fix all the condiments myself, so I don't have a need for the condiment tray on the back. And that's all my permits and all that stuff. And these are my napkins right here. But this is the big dog. And the big dog also has, in here, it has a freshwater tank. It's got a battery in the corner in there and a pump right there in that corner. All right. And then on the other side, you've got two propane tanks, two 20-pound propane tanks. They're right there in the other side. And then you've got a cooler right here. You can get a deep a mechanical cooler. This is a non-mechanical cooler. And it's plenty big enough for everything that I do. It's kind of messy right now because I'm actually working today. But that's weird. I'm working. And then there's my sinks. I actually have three sinks. Two on this side and one big one over there. And then here I have my condiment tray. And this is my steam table. A big dog actually has a larger steam table than most hot dog carts. Most hot dog carts only has from here to here, which is a full-size pan. And that's my fresh baked buns. But if you see the perforated pans that I've got in here, let me move these hot dogs around. But they got little holes in them. And then there's a big steam pan underneath that's got water in it. And then this right here is a direct heat pan. Sometimes I'll leave broke hot dogs in there, and the reason I do is it flavors the water. And but that's a 6-inch direct heat pan. And then next to that is a 1/3 pan. And then I have my little 1/6 pans. They're right there. Or I think they're 1/8. But anyway, there they are. And I put sauerkraut in here, and I actually have water in the bottom of that one, and it turns it into a miniature steam pan. And then on my big dog, I actually have a grill. That's my grill. And this is my condiment tray, because I fix all the condiments myself. I got relish and onions, and then I've got sweet peppers, hot peppers, and then I have cheese in the cooler over there and mayonnaise, which I keep separate. And then I have mustard ketchup, special sauce, which is my sauce that I make. And I actually have spicy brown mustard today. Most of the time I don't have that, but sometimes I do. And anyway, but that's pretty much the tour of the big dog. My hot water heater is actually under here, but on most hot dog carts, from a hot dog cart store, they put the hot water heater here. The reason mine's not here is because I wanted three shelves, and they added an extra shelf in here. Most come with just one shelf. I wanted two. All these things I keep saying that I wanted, they cost. So when you order that, you need to take that into consideration that, you know, hey, this is going to cost. And then my tongue has actually been reinforced here. I've got half-inch angle iron on there, or all the way around. And that's just one of my preferences. And then, of course, I got 8-inch wheels, like every other hot dog cart. And the cart is actually solid stainless steel. It normally shines more, but I've been busy this morning. Every time I see a spot, I just want to wipe it off. I don't know why. You'd think I was a hot dog man or something. But, yeah, anyway. But and then I have a tray here, or shelf here, that is added. Most hot dog carts that come, they have a handlebar here, or just a handle here and a handle here at this end. Mine actually has a shelf here. I like the shelf, but heed this warning, this shelf will get hot, so you can't just set anything on it, because it will melt. I mean it like gets really, really hot right there. And but I just use it to fix the dogs, and that's all I use it for. Every now and then I'll set my these trays right here. I use 2 and 3 pound trays, and I'll set them because the heat doesn't bother them. But like if you set your tinfoil up there, it'll actually melt the tinfoil. Anyway, all right. And then that's my bread box. I have a lock on my bread box right here, and you just open it up, and that's all the stuff that I keep inside the bread box. You can keep bread in there too, but, and there's my menus and my drink display. And then also your hot dog cart's gonna come with an umbrella too. And that's a huge umbrella. It's bigger than the cart. But it's really nice umbrella. And then there's my coolers over there that's got all my drinks in it, and I've got extra ice there. I'm backing up so y'all can actually see what the big dog looks like. It is not that big. It's called a big dog because you can feed 1,000 people in an hour off of a big dog and a Cater Pro. The reason I know that and the reason I say that is because we've done it. We fed 1,000 people and all we had is a Cater Pro and a big dog. So if you don't believe it, we got a video to prove it. All right, y'all have a good day. This is Doug's Dogs, and y'all know we're good.